Anyway, it's Blogger with a Cuppa, a bit of a rant going to go on here, and it's about stupid people. I just don't know what to do. I'm on the lookout for another new job, again. But I really don't know what I want to do, because there's just too many stupid people. Every single job I go to, you're going to come across stupid people. Now, I'm not talking about people with disabilities or anything like that. I can deal with that. I've got good customer service. I can deal with that. That is fine. There's a difference. I'm talking about stupid people, rude people. Bear with me. I'm going to have to do this real quick because I nearly drank all my coffee, because this is about the 10th time I've done this, because I try and get it under 20 minutes. Anyway, okay. Examples of stupid and rude people. And let's start with the woman in Argos with the jewellery she'd bought. It was Christmas time, really, really busy. I only remember it was collection point D because it was the fairest possible distance from the jewellery counter. Really, really busy. She'd bought like about 10 items of jewellery. And she comes up to the counter. Well, she comes up to the counter, 10 items of jewellery. I said to her, oh, if you wait at the jewellery counter, you'd be served a lot faster. And you'd be out a lot faster because the place was rammed, do you know what I mean? And she says, well, she didn't say anything, she slammed it up like this and she walks over. She's probably in a mood because she's probably waited quite a long time to pay for the items. That's the only reason I could think of, unless she is just utterly rude for no reason. Anyway, just 5 minutes later, she comes back and she's shouting and screaming at me how she's made me wait and how I made her wait in another queue. And I said, you walked over. And I said, if you wait over there, it'd be a lot quicker because we've got to wait at the jewellery counter, but they're out serving other people. If you've shopped in Argos, you know what I mean, don't you? You pay to get your items, and you either go to the jewellery counter or the collection point to pick up your items. And this was like a massive Argos shop. Oh, she's actually going for moaning. And it actually took her longer to get her items because she was too stupid enough to wait at the jewellery counter. Let's stay with Argos, actually, and this woman comes in with a cooker. She's got two sons, so I could drag it in. And she's refusing to leave the shop because this cooker's been condemned. And the electrician said we should be taken to trading standards, and she's going to go on watchdog. And she's really kicking off about this cooker. Really in our face, really shouting. And about 15 minutes later, I had to get the manager because I was on customer services. And he obviously tries to undermine me then, obviously, as managers do. And I said, oh, have you got your receipt on yet? And she slams it into my hand. She slams the receipt in my hand and she's still shouting, he's still apologising. This receipt's for Index. She'd come into the wrong shop. Does an apology come my way? No, it doesn't. She then storms out the shop still shouting how rubbish Argos is and how that cooker's condemned and it's dangerous, shouting to all the other customers and everything like that. I look at my manager thinking, well, are you going to apologise to me? Because now you just made me look like, and I feel like horrible now. And he doesn't, he just walks off. Do you know what I mean? That's going for three for Argos. This man with a lawnmower, he paid £50 for a lawnmower. And I had to carry it down the stairs because the lift's broken. It's 50 kilograms, his lawnmower. And not 50 kilograms, but 30 kilograms. Really heavy. Brings the person down. It's kicking off because he's waited a long time. He's waited about 5 minutes, but when you're waiting in an Argos queue, it can feel longer than that. So he's moaning because it's covered in dust. That's probably been in the stock room for years. What are you doing, mate? You can't give me that. Oh, sorry, sir. Goes up the stairs, it's found the lawnmower. You know, my elbow's grazing against the wall because it's massive. It's really horrible. And then brings down the second one. It's got a tiny hole in it like that. Kicks over you from worse. You don't know what you're doing, mate. You're crap at your job. What do you think you're doing? I don't want that. I goes upstairs again. The third one's probably has been kicked on the stockroom. You know, boxes dented on the side, rippled packaging. He's already got the manager. He's complaining about the manager to me. Saying, I don't know what I'm doing and why do I have a job this, that and the other. And I'm like, oh my God, why has it been like this? So anyway, I go upstairs. And I get the first one, dust it off, and I give it to him. But he's still shouting and everything to my manager. They didn't realise that he's got the first lawnmower. And he walks off without his receipt. So I hope his lawnmower broke and he didn't get a refund or replacement. Then there was a woman at Boots. She wanted a refund on a 2/3 empty SlimFast tin because she'd not lost any weight. And during the conversation of her arguing with me, of how it's a con and it's against trade's description of whatever. I said, it comes out, but she's still been eating the meals with this milkshake. I said, well, the milkshake's meant to be a meal. And she goes, oh, no. You don't stand, you got to eat. Yeah, like that. Do you know what I mean? And then she does that look, which is always an annoying look. The patronising look. Ooh, do you know what I mean? You know that look. Someone at Iceland did that. It was the middle of the horse meat scandal. And he comes by and says, oh, is that full of horse meat? Was doing a stock take at the time. I said, no, this is just a stock take. And he goes, yeah, I don't believe yet. Like that. And he still goes to the till and buys stuff. And this man constantly moaned and complained about everything. Do you know what I mean? Like, even if you left the trolleys in the wrong place, he'd moan. It's like, if you don't like somewhere, you don't shop in there, do you? You know what I mean? You just don't shop in there. I don't like Next. I do not like Barclays. I hate Next so much. You'll only see me in there if I'm cutting through there. Do you know what I mean? And even then, I'll probably scowl at the stuff. Do you know what I mean? But I won't say anything because I can't stand the shop. So I'll just walk through it and get out and I'll walk by it without looking at Next. Same with Barclays. My subscribers know about me and Barclays. Rubbish customer service. Awful place. I got rid of Barclays. I don't bank there anymore. And then lastly, let's go to where I'm working now. I get this group of people, probably about 10, maybe 15 people. This woman looks dead into my eyes. Is this suitable for vegetarians because I can't have gluten? She says it with such conviction and stares into my eyes, it confuses me. And I'm like, you're a vegetarian and you can't also have gluten? She looks at her friends and she gives her this patronising grin laugh thing. She goes, he doesn't know what he's doing, he doesn't know what he's talking about. And she looks dead into my eyes again. No, I'm a vegetarian. I want to know if it's got gluten in it. She confuses me. I go to the kitchen. I already know that I'm right. Or have I been wrong all these years of knowing this information? I go into the kitchen and I say, gluten's wheat, gelatin, animal, yeah? That simple. And they're like, look at me as if I'm crazy and they ask me to repeat it. And I'm right, aren't I? Gelatin is from an animal, gluten is wheat. And they're like, of course it is. What are you talking about? I said, I'll be back in a minute. I goes out and say, well, it is suitable for vegetarians, but it has got gluten in it. And she's going, I don't speak to the manager, you don't know what you're talking about. And I said, do you mean gelatin? It's not got gelatin in it, but it has got gluten in it. She still complains because apparently I've embarrassed her. She's embarrassed herself! You know what I mean? Ugh! Anyway, that is just a short, tiny little seed of annoyances of how stupid people are. When they leave the common sense and their brains in the doorway and they walk into somewhere and they're complete idiots and they're wrong. And I just don't know what to do with my life anymore. I can't deal with this anymore. If I work anywhere, I'm going to come across this, aren't I? Is there a job out there where I work? Is there a job out there, there must be, where I don't have to deal with stupid people? Please come in. Am I wrong? Am I being wrong? Should I put up with this? I don't understand why people are so rude and horrible for no reason to customer sales advisors and this, that and the other for no reason. Unless they are fiercely rude and horrible to you, then by all means, and I do, I go all out on them. I really do. But don't be rude for unnecessarily mean reasons, just because you're in a bad... It's just so unkind. And I'm fed up of it. I'm just fed up of it. And I'm trying to find a job out there where I won't have to deal with stupid people. I mean, I've got tact. You know what I mean? Some of these stupid people I can deal with, you know. But... I just don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. What should I do? Please comment, rate and subscribe. Tell me, there's got to be a job out there for me. I'm fed up. And it's fine.